मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, माई नेम इज़ एलिजाबेथ टीचर एंड फ्रॉम टूडे ऑनवर्ड्स आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू फिफ्थ स्टैंडर्ड इंग्लिश. सो बिफोर दैट आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू चिल्ड्रन बी सेफ एंड बी हेल्दी एट होम एंड वॉट एवर वी आर गोइंग टू टीच यू जस्ट लिसन केयरफुली एंड गो थ्रू इट. मीन्स यू हैव टू स्टडी एट होम. ओके, सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द लेसन आई वॉन्ट टू आस्क यू फ्यू क्वेश्चंस. यू आर रेडी टू आंसर? ओके. सो Do you like to play games? Yes, everyone likes to play games, isn't it? Young or either the old people, they like to play games. Now, next I want to ask you, which are the games familiar you are with? Yeah, you all are familiar with hockey, football, and of course, cricket. Okay, so next I want to ask you, can you name some of the cricketers of Indian team? Yes, Mahendra Singh Dhoni, Virat Kohli, Hardik Pandya, and of course the wonder boy Sachin Tendulkar. Very good. Now next I want to ask you, see, this lesson is based on cricket, so do you know what all things are needed to play the game cricket? Anybody can answer it? Yes, ball, stumps, cricket pad, gloves, knee pad. Oh children, one thing is missing that is very important. Yes, the bat, which we have to use it to swing in the air. That is bat. So today, I'm going to tell you a wonderful story about a bat that is missing. So we are going through this lesson, the story, The Missing Bat. And this story is written by Vaishali Shroff. She is a great writer. She has taken all the stories from one book and you have to listen it very carefully. And one thing I want to tell you, when I just go on teaching the lesson, you have to underline the hard words. And whatever meanings I'm going to give on the board, you are going to write it down as well. Some of the articles that are there, you are going to underline it. Okay, means you are going to listen to the story, you are going to learn the meanings as well as some grammar part. Okay, so let's start with the story. So I know you all are very happy after many days you are going to listen to me, and this is the story, very beautiful, wonderful story. You all hope you all are going to enjoy it. Now here you see Abdul Rahman Chacha. He is an old man, but he is very, very particular. And he owned a big cricket bat factory in Sangam near Srinagar. Now this Srinagar is in Jammu and Kashmir. This Srinagar and this Sangam place is very, very famous place where the cricket bats are made. And do you know, Sachin Tendulkar's bat is also from here. So do you like to bring the bat from this place? Yes. And these bats are made out of willow trees which we get in this place, Sangam. So this Abdul Rahman Chacha, he owned a big cricket bat factory. He was having a big cricket bat factory in Sangam, which is near Srinagar. One could see cricket bats neatly stacked, underline the word stacked, and in rows all around his factory. Stacked means to pile upon one another, or to keep the bats one upon the other. They were arranged very properly in the factory. Then next we see Chacha was an old man with a hunchback. Now you know children, old people, they just bend down, and this bending of down is called as hunchback. So underline that word hunchback. Before that, I would like to tell you to underline a big cricket bat. A big cricket bat is an article, a big. See, we use article a and the before the adjective, isn't it? So this underline a big cricket bat and just write down there an article. So now we came here that this Chacha, he was an old man with a hunchback. He was always frowning, underline frowning, and you just write down the meaning. You write down the meaning. Frowning means he was worried, because this meaning is not there in the lesson. So I am giving the meaning. Frowning is the meaning. Worried is the meaning of the word frowning. He was always worried and always on his feet. Always on his feet means he was not walking on his feet. He was very much alert and he was very much hard worker. Always whole day he used to roam around in the factory and was back of the workers to see whether those workers are doing their work very properly. Then tapping his walking stick as he went. Do you know children, these old people, they have a stick in their hand and used to hold the stick in his hand, tapping his stick, and as he went all around the factory. And he was trying to see what his workers were doing. Just he was saying that whether all the workers are doing the work properly. Amir was a worker at Chacha's factory. Now here one more character we have in the story, that is Amir. He was father of Ahmed and he was also working in this Chacha's factory. He was a great worker, he was a poor man and he was very hard working person. Ahmed stayed with him at the factory every day after school. This Ahmed was a small boy and daily he used to visit his father's factory to see how my father works, and he was very much fond of those bats. He was crazy of those bats. So daily he used to go to that factory after the school and used to watch what his father was working over there. Then he would stare at the tall stacks of cricket bats in awe. And whenever he used to come to the factory, he was just standing and looking at all the bats as if he was thinking that I should get at least one bat from this factory. He was just looking in awe. Awe means very, with a surprising, used to look at the bats. He liked to hold and run his fingers across the bats. Do you know children, the surface of that bat is very smooth, isn't it? I like that surface of the bat. It is very smooth. Even this Ahmed, he used to like that bat and used to run his fingers on the bat. He used to feel that smoothness of the bat. And after his father had shaped them with his machine, after shaping that bat with the machine, it was very smooth and he loved that smoothness. This Ahmed, he was very much fond of those old stacks of the bat and he was thinking that one day I should get this bat. My father is working here, but he never bought a bat for me. So always he was in that craze that I need a bat from here. Gripping by its handle, he would swing it in the air. One day, what he did, you know, he took one bat in his hand. And gripping means what? He hold it very firmly. He hold the bat in his hand with a flick of his wrist. He hold the bat by its handle and he would swing it in the air with a flick of his wrist. What he did? He swing it in the air with his wrist, as if Sachin Tendulkar had hit the shot in the air, and he was very happy with that. Means he was thinking that I am playing on the ground and I am playing the cricket and I am front of some big, means very powerful team. And he was, what he did, as if he was thinking some player is playing a ball and I am hitting the bat and I am hitting the shot over there. So he was very, very happy while playing with this bat. Next, and write down the meaning for the gripping. Underline the word gripping and write down the meaning. Hold firmly. So this boy, he was very happy after holding the bat. But one day, what happened? This Chacha, you know, this old man, he was very particular. And what it is this Chacha, what happened? If Chacha got Ahmed with a bat in his hand, this Chacha just looked at Ahmed and he saw that a bat was in Ahmed's hands. He would clear his throat and say, That's not a plaything boy. Put it back. Under Chacha's watchful eye, this boy got very scared. And what he did? He went and kept the bat in its place. Ahmad would put the bat in its place. He used to go running and put the bat in its place. And then Chacha was just staring at that boy. Ahmad would put the bat in its place. Did the old man know that he dreamed of being Sachin Tendulkar someday? This poor man, he was not knowing that this boy was, means he loved to be Sachin Tendulkar. And he did not know that, means he was worried that I want to become Sachin Tendulkar. But this poor man, he was not knowing that he has to play like Sachin Tendulkar. Then one day what happened? This old man, he was a bit worried why this boy often he comes to this factory and look around this all. But he was not knowing this boy has dreamed that one day he would be Sachin Tendulkar because he used to like play cricket. Then if you see next, Chacha was very particular about his talk. This Chacha, he was very dangerous man. And he was very particular about his talk. Every day with a miser, he was very miser, na? So every day he used to go and check that and count those bats. He liked to count the number of bats. Every day he was going on counting it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and go on. So every day he used to count the number of bats in his warehouse. You know, children, he did this every evening. Every evening he used to count. See, so tired we get every day counting the same things, isn't it? This old man, he was having a lot of energy. Means nice food he used to have. So he was having a lot of energy. And daily used to sit and count that bats. Every evening before the workers left for home. Why before the workers left for home? Because he was thinking, suppose if any worker would carry the bat after the warehouse is locked, so that he won't understand who has stolen the bat. So what he used to do? Every evening before the workers leave, he used to start counting the bats. Okay, now my stock is as it is. So he was very happy with that. And every morning also, as soon as he used to come very early, in the morning only used to come before the workers come. Before the workers going used to come and before the workers come, he used to start counting the stock in the early morning. As he loaded the bats onto his truck and after counting the bats, he used to load the bats in the truck to sell it. He had imagined how he would play detective. This Chacha, he was a big player also, like a detective. Means he used to detect everything. He used to play detective, plan detective. If any of his bats went missing, and if any bat was missing, he was playing a detective. And everybody was scared of him, so nobody dared to touch one bat also from that warehouse. Then, if you see next, and then it happened. One day, something was going to go wrong, and that happened one day. One morning, when Chacha opened the warehouse, he came there, he opened the warehouse to take the stock out. Come on, now he started removing one by one the bat and load it onto his truck. And he started loading one by one, take here and put there in the truck. So one by one he started doing that. He found that there was one bat missing. Oh my God, today one bat is missing. I'm not understanding where. Yesterday evening I've counted all the bats and they were all as it is. But where is the one bat? So he was not understanding at all. He was furious. Underline the word furious and write down the meaning. Furious means he was very angry. He was very angry. Now he was very angry. He was not understanding where I have kept the bat. And he was going on thinking, yesterday I had counted all the bats and where are the bats now? So he was very, very furious and he thought that where would have that bat missed up now? So because he had admired the bat just the previous evening, just yesterday evening I have counted the bats and in a night, where the bat disappeared, he was worried about it and he was very, very angry on that. It was the biggest and the lightest one of all. Dear children, it might be his favorite bat, I think, because it was the lightest and it was the biggest bat of all these bats. That afternoon, Chacha gathered the workers and made them stand in a row. Come on, stand in front of me. I want to talk to everyone. Where is the bat missing? Come on, I want the answer now. He started asking them. All the workers, they were shivering because Chacha was very angry. He made everyone to stand in front of him and he started asking, come on, tell me where is the bat? I want the bat. They were all shivering because Chacha was very angry and they thought, now today we are not going to escape from his anger. Then one bat is missing. Where do you think it could have gone? The workers looked down. They all looked down and shook their heads as if they want to tell Chacha, we don't know anything. They found it difficult to look at Chacha when he was angry. They were very much afraid and they were not able to look at him at all. So they put their heads down and they just shook their head and said, no, Chacha, we don't know anything. But this Chacha, he was very angry. Now he was supposed to start playing the detective. The workers looked down and shook their heads. They said, no, Chacha, we don't know. They found it difficult to look at Chacha when he was angry. They were very much worried and they did not try to look at Chacha because they know Chacha is very angry now today. No one other than you all and me enters the warehouse. He said, no one is there. Me and you all people, then where has the bat gone? So where is it? Shouted Chacha. Where is it? I want the bat just now here. Chacha started shouting on them. His eyes found Amir. As he was tearing all the work, he just found to Amir. Oh, Amir. A bat can't disappear overnight, can it? He asked. You are right, Chacha. It can't, Amir agreed. Where is Amir today? Amir? I do not see him around. He's asking Amir with a doubt. Now they are having a doubt that Ahmed might have stolen the bat. But poor child, why he was thinking? Because this Ahmed, he was very much fond of the bats, isn't it? So he was thinking that Ahmed only has stolen the bat and today he has escaped. Today he didn't come. Every day used to come to the warehouse. But today only, why he didn't come over there? Now he had a great doubt on that Ahmed. And looking at Amir, is asking, where is Ahmed today? Why didn't he come today? I want the answer. Then Ahmed is not well, Chacha. He is replying very politely and he is very nervous today. And he is saying, no, Chacha, Ahmed is not well. He is resting at home today. Amir answered, now looking straight at the other man. And this Amir, he came to know this man, old man is doubting my son. So straight he was looking at Chacha and he was saying, no, Chacha, because no one was dared to look at that old man. But this time Amir, he was facing to that man and he was saying, no, Chacha, my Amir is not well. And so he didn't come today. So please don't doubt on him. Suddenly, one by one, the workers began to giggle. All of you they started laughing. Chacha's beard quivered in anger. Like that, he started shouting. His beard started shaking with anger. And he shouted, what is so amusing? Amir began to study his toes again. He started, what is so amusing? Are you thinking I am a fool? I am cracking jokes over here. You all are laughing over there. What is going on? Just tell me. Upon hearing him shout, everyone burst into laughter. All they started laughing at them. We found the missing bat, Chacha. We found the missing bat, exclaimed Amir. Chacha was very quiet. Why these people are saying like this? These people are with me. And how they are saying we found a missing bat? Surely this had to be some joke, thought Chacha. Chacha thought, these people are cracking jokes on me. They are making me a fool. He didn't think he could get any angry. Then he already was. Now he was very angry. Hey, you all shut up. Why you all are laughing at me? You understand? I have missed the bat and you all people are cracking jokes. You are making me a fool. What is this? I want the missing bat today. Otherwise, I am not going to let you out of this warehouse. I want it at any cost today. You have been standing in front of me all this time. So how could you say that we have found it? He spat out. He was shouting so loudly that he spat, means he spit there. And so loudly he was shouting and asking, "Are you all people are standing in front of me here and I'm here and where you got the missing bat? Tell me, I want the answer now." Eyes shining a big grin on his face, Amir, like this smile is giving to that old man. Amir pointed at Chacha's walking stick. "Chacha, see your stick." The old man looked down. "My God, it is with me." So he also started laughing. And so loudly started laughing. None of the workers had known until that day that Chacha could laugh so loud. So loudly started laughing. "My God, this stick is with me. This bat is with me. And I'm searching in my warehouse. So silly thing it is." Or that he wore dentures. And he laughed so loudly. You know that old people, they have the dentures. Dentures means what? False teeth. He laughed so loudly, they all could see his false teeth. And then he realized that, really, these people are very honest workers. They would have never done such thing with me. And he was very happy with them. And then he realized that I have done a big mistake, that I have doubted these people. And that was not at all good. So, here I want to tell you something, children. Can you tell me what you have learned from this story? Anybody? Yes? Yes. That we are not supposed to judge anybody else without any reason. Until and unless, or we can't blame any person without any reason, because we don't know what is the situation. Or what is the reason behind it? Just we have to find out the solution, or just we have to find out first the reason. What is the thing? What we have done? Or what is the situation around it? So this thing had happened. And once you found the reason, then you have the right to judge anybody else or to blame anybody else. And after blaming also, you have to give a chance to the person that he should correct himself in that way, and next time he won't do that mistake again. So children, did you like all this thing what I have taught you, or this lesson? Yes, everyone liked the story, isn't it? You all enjoyed. So I think, children, you have to be like this, like particular about this Ahmed, like this old Chacha. And you have to particularly how he was doing everything daily, particular same thing. Particularly, you have to study every day whatever is taught by the teachers. And now I want to give you some homework. So if you see page number one, here you can see the meanings: Chacha, stacked, hunchback. Then turn the page. Flick, play detective, overnight. Next page, giggle, quivered, and dentures. These all meanings you are going to write in your notebook as your homework. Plus, you are going to write all the hard words from page number 1, page number 2, and page number 3. So, you copy down the homework in your notebook. Copy down the homework. Just I'll give you half a minute. Copy down this homework. okay. Now we are going to solve the textbook. Okay, open page number 4. Open page number 4. Can you see here? Take the correct answer, everyone. Yes, take the correct answer. Open a textbook. Page number 4. Take the correct answer. B question. From that first one, if you see, Ahmed liked to hold the bats his father made because. Which is the correct answer? Tick over there. Which is the correct answer? Yes, B one. Tick mark over there. Next, second one. We know that Abdul Rahman Chacha was a suspicious man. Suspicious means what, dear? Yes, he was very dangerous man, isn't it? Because, what is the correct answer? Yes, A one. He always walked around to see what his workers were doing. Next, third one. Abdul Rahman Chacha asked Amir where Ahmed was because, which is the correct answer? C one. He thought that the boy had stolen the bat. Fourth one. Amir looked straight at Abdul Rahman Chacha because, yeah, the correct answer. He wanted to make it clear that Ahmed was not a thief. And last, Abdul Rahman Chacha laughed loudly when the bat was found. This shows that the answer, he realized that his reaction to the situation was not correct. Okay? Have you done with this? Okay. Next, see page number 5. Page number 5. Complete these sentences with the correct forms of the verbs in brackets. Now, can you see here some words are there in the brackets. Buy, park, read, watch, not tell. So, these words you are going to write in the past tense now. First answer is given for you. Arpana has bought. The past tense of buy they have given as bought. Has bought some books for her birthday. Second, if you see, Sudipto. What is the correct answer? Yes. Has parked. Has parked. Write down. Has parked. Next, if you see, here they have given the word read in the bracket. So, what will be the correct answer? Yes. Here the question is there. So, you are going to ask a question from did or do. Did you read the latest Tinkle Digest? Did you? Did you read the latest Tinkle Digest? Next, I dash already watched this film. I had already watched. Had already. Watched. And last is, did she not tell you the news yet? Did she tell? Did she tell? Okay. Hope you all love this story. So, do the homework. Goodbye and see you again back. So, be particular with your studies. Thank you, children. Have a nice day and be safe. Stay home. Don't go outside. Okay. Thank you.